brothers and sisters, I needed to put this video out because it was just really strange to me. Very strange. So here I am in the process of doing multiple videos. I just got done breaking night, recording a new dinner table sermon, and I'm telling you, this message has changed my life. So be on the lookout for it. I'm also finishing up a video exposing a form of witchcraft that I don't hear anybody talking about. And as you guys are waiting for the documentary, It's Worse Than You Think Part 2, make sure you've seen Part 1 on our website. But with that being said, y'all, as busy as we are, I had to stop and do this video. So as I'm editing and kind of going back and forth, I'm seeing this buzz online about a video from Vogue, which we know is an Illuminati company, of Kim Kardashian just kind of showing off her daughter's paintings. And it just felt weird to me. It felt staged. And as y'all know, as children of God, we should never accuse or assume. So I'm just laying this out here as a possibility, and I'll let you decide. And if you have a spiritual discernment and eyes to see and ears to hear, you know that the Luciferians in Hollywood, they love to talk in coded language. They love to reveal things hidden in plain sight. In fact, it's called lesser magic. Now, the irony is the children of God, because of persecution on social media, we are not even allowed to mention certain words, if you know what I'm talking about, because they will take videos down and ultimately remove channels. So the irony is the children of God now have to also speak in a way where you understand what we're saying without us saying it. But let me hurry up because I got to get back to editing. Y'all, this was crazy. Now, because I didn't want to get a copyright strike, I took a lot of screenshots. You can watch the video on your own time if you're led. So the video starts off with Kim Kardashian showing her daughter's paintings. Now, the first one is beautiful. There's a mountain and trees, and it's so beautiful. It looks like a paradise. Makes me want to flee to the mountains, if you know what I mean. It makes me want to go to the mountain and pray like Christ Yeshua did. But then it switches immediately. She says, oh, this is a painting my daughter did of a wolf. Okay, all right, no doubt, you know, all right, a wolf, you know. But then she goes on to show a bearded dragon. And I'm like, wait a minute, wait. You go from a wolf to a dragon. Then it takes a turn for the worst. And it's a picture. I don't know if it was her own daughter or just a picture of a girl. But she has what appears to be a serpent tongue coming out of her mouth. What appears to be tears coming down her left eye. And some form of a mark on her forehead. And she looks like she's coming out of a pit. So let's rewind. Let's go back to the picture of the wolf. Now, before we continue, you might be like, man, this brother's bugging. He's just reaching. Look, I ain't mad at you. You got your own opinion. I'm only telling you how I felt when I seen the video. Because I'm not the type to click on all these celebrity videos. There's a lot of YouTubers. They love to get a whole lot of views. They're always talking about celebrities. And they're looking for anything and everything to talk about. Any type of theory. Y'all know we stick to mainly Christ teachings. Dinner table messages. And occasional exposed videos. And sometimes music videos. So although you're entitled to your opinion, I'm just sharing what I was seeing in the spirit. It just seemed odd to me. It might not seem odd to you. But what does the wolf represent? I couldn't help but think of Ezekiel 22:27, where it talks about how wolves ravening the prey to shed blood and to destroy souls. to get dishonest gain. And you think about what this abomination does to the body and how it changes the person. Like I said, I gotta be careful how I say it. It's up to you to know what I'm talking about. And we know how Christ warned us in John 10 verse 12, how if someone doesn't care for the flock and they're not the shepherd, they see the wolf, they running. And the wolf is going to catch those sheep and scatter them. We know that Christ warned us in Matthew 7, 15 to beware of false prophets, which come to you in sheep's clothing, but inward they're ravening wolves. But the one that should stand out to you is Acts 20, 29. Paul says that I know that after I'm departing, grievous wolves will enter in among you, not sparing the flock. So we know what wolves represent in the Bible. And we know who the chief wolf is. Because if Jesus is the Lion of Judah, if he is the Lion of all lions, who is the wolf of all wolves? It's the Antichrist with his false prophet. But then she goes on to mention the bearded dragon. But what does the book of Revelation talk about when it comes to the dragon? So when she showed this bearded dragon, when you go to Revelation chapter 12, verse 9, it says, and the great dragon was cast out, that old serpent called the devil and Satan, which deceived the whole world. But how did he deceive the whole world? How was he able to trick billions? Well, when you parallel that to Revelation 18, and I'm not going to talk, and I'm not going to mention certain words, you're going to have to read it yourself. But in Revelation 18, it shows you how he deceived the whole world. And there's a certain word, and there's a certain word called sorcery. Why don't you do a little homework and figure out what sorcery means in Greek and put two and two together? But then when she showed this image of a little girl, I don't know if it's her actual daughter, with what looks to be tears coming down her left eye and a long serpent tongue coming out of her mouth and some form of a mark on her forehead, looking like she's coming out of a bottomless pit. Revelation 9:11 talks about a bottomless pit. But it wasn't just the picture, it was what Kim Kardashian said when she showed the picture. She mentioned a certain name, and if you look carefully, the subtitles are on the screen. But then she mentions how, oh, this drawing was done with charcoal. And I'm like, why are you giving unnecessary information? Unless, so just out of a hunch, I just went online because I wanted to know if charcoal has any connection with a certain type of material that a lot of people who've been kicked off of YouTube, even scientists, were warning us is in the snake bite, the abomination. And when I looked it up, lo and behold, charcoal is related and connected to this particular material that has been known to have a connection and do something to a human body while being touched by frequencies, if you know what I mean. That's the best I can do, brothers and sisters, as far as talking without getting a strike, because what you have to know is that YouTube is monitored by the beast system, and this, the image of the beast is alive right now. It listens, it watches billions of people at the same time through the power of the supercomputers the internet. And you would know this if you have watched It's Worse Than You Think Part 1. So we have to be careful how we say things. We have to be wise as serpents and harmless as doves. So was Kim Kardashian giving us a message, a hidden message? I know from what I hear, she's for. From what I hear, she is for the abomination. And her husband has been known to speak against the abomination. And y'all know how I feel about Kanye West. I did a song warning him a couple years back. But this is not for you to accuse or assume. It's just for you to think and meditate and kind of put what you believe is two and two together. Hey, that's just me thinking. I was just in the mood to talk to y'all real quick and get your opinion on the matter. You know, I usually don't do videos like this. When I do exposed videos, they're very well planned out. A whole lot of prayer goes into it. A lot of scriptures. But I just had to let y'all know about this because it seemed very strange. And the final thing I want to warn you guys about. Remember that we have been praying for God to give us grace and extend our time to get closer together in Christ while we're able to. And to get closer together in Christ and prepare for more persecution. Because it's already begun, y'all. Look around you. Look at other countries. You cannot base biblical prophecy only based on what is going on in one or two countries. You have to look across the earth. And did you know a video just came out of an FDA exec on camera revealing the future snake bite policies? I'm talking about forced abomination. He goes on to say how it hasn't been formally announced. They don't want to rile up the people. But he said it's coming. So when you see them backing away, it's called spiritual warfare. It's called psychological warfare. It's like how they'll give you back your freedom and then take it away again to make you angry and hate those who they say is the reason you don't have your freedom. They want to breed hatred into the hearts of the people that have taken the abomination to hate those who refuse to be marked. Remember, the Antichrist will wear out the saints. He will change times and laws. Do not be deceived by the Trojan horse tactic. And look around you. You see wars and rumors of wars. Are you ready to meet the Messiah, Almighty God? Are you ready? I would advise you, if the most important thing about you watching this video is not because of some paintings at the Kardashians' house, it's so you can get right with Christ. Pray more. Read your word while you can. Put it in your heart. Fast often. And don't forsake the assembling of yourselves together with the saints of God. Love your enemies. Seek Christ while he may be found. And pray for us as we're praying for you. Because every knee will bow and every tongue will confess that Jesus Christ, Yeshua the Almighty, is Lord. To the glory of God the Father.